Are you looking for that perfect piece to be the focal point of your fan cave? Or something that will light up your office? Fly the Wood Designs creates unique custom, made-to-order lighted wood pieces to highlight your favorite team, company logo, or whatever you're looking for. One client said they took my logo and made it better. Easily work with them and create exactly what you envision, or give them artistic freedom to create something incredible. Many of these attention-grabbing pieces are displayed in spaces of Cubs players, businesses, and corporate offices. Find Fly the Wood Designs on social at Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. You can also contact the wood artist, Bill Watts, at woodflags1@gmail.com. Fly the Wood, fan cave, bar, and home decor.
All aboard!
Let's get ready to rumble!
We're Cubs fans helping Cubs fans at Stewart's Cubs cave parties. Everybody's in for giving back to those in need. We're going to Club 400.
The Club 400 podcast is on the air. And William, I'm going to ask you a question, right?
I'm ready. Fire away.
I haven't been excited this much since...
blank.
Yeah. Since? What's your answer?
Your birthday.
You care about my birthday that much? Is that your answer right now?
No. Oh, since the Cubs won the World Series in 2016.
That's the proper answer.
Ding, 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 ding.
Jesus.
What have I won?
You know how many times we went over this show before we came on live here?
And what did I win? Did I win something for that answer or no?
I'll tell you what, you guys, you don't win anything except that you do win the fact that you're going to attend this party Thursday, August 17th at Club 400, 6 o'clock to 10 o'clock, right here in the famous Club 400.
The famous.
I just said famous for the first time.
I'm glad that you call it the famous Club 400.
It's the first time I've ever said that.
Usually when we're out in public, you're like, I have this wacky man cave. it's not wacky.
No,
it's not really crazy. It's crazy. I don't know. Wacky, crazy.
I never know how to explain it.
It's heaven.
It's basically.
My basement is heaven.
Basically, it's Cub fans helping Cub fans, man.
That is basically it. That nails, that hits home.
And you know, William, that was the one thing I wanted to start off tonight. We got a lot to go over tonight, by the way. Goodness. I mean, we got to squeeze this.
A lot of
information coming out tonight.
All you people who are listening, get your popcorn.
Yeah.
Strap it on. We're going.
William actually put in a little extra time on this show, which I'm really surprised at. I mean, he was actually thinking about it last night at like midnight.
Well, you put the pressure on, Stu. Let's just be honest.
No, I honestly do. I mean, I told William, like, how many times can we do a podcast and announce an event like this?
You actually didn't tell me that. You told everybody that on Facebook. So,
like, we actually have a podcast. We have something really great. We're going to break some really great news to everybody tonight. And, I mean, it's going to be fun, man.
We're
going to
have a blast. Yeah, so, let's do it.
But, yeah, first of all, you know, one of the questions, William, I get asked all the time is, what is Club 400, right? What is Club 400?
What is Club 400?
And I'll tell you what, as you guys know, our loyal listeners know, we dropped the What is Club 400 video. My guy Sam from X-Ray Productions, me and him, we worked together, but he is the main man that made me look so great. And there was no filters used, by the way, because, William, I did look pretty good in that video.
You did. I got it.
I thought I could see my abs come through the T-shirt
sexy.
A little bit. I mean, not bad, dude.
Kind of sexy.
I was like, yeah. Oh. But anyways, I'll tell you what, guys. Be honest with you, I'm so proud of that video.
You know what? If you had never heard of this, and if you're, I don't know, under a rock living in the area, that would be the only way you've never heard of Club 400. But if you've never heard of Club 400, it is like the perfect, well, how long is it?
It's 5 minutes.
It's a perfect 5-minute explanation of what it is. I mean, it sums it up. It nails it. It's like, yeah, you and Sam hit that one out of the park.
There's yeah, I give it all to Sam, and it was a idea that her, Sam and Nicole came up with a while ago, and like it just made a lot of sense to do this video, like honestly. And now, like when someone asked me about Club 400, you I can just simply send them the video.
Yeah.
In fact, I did a Zoom call the other day, and with Smitty, our good guy Phil Smith. And I said, hey, Smitty, because he's pretty technical. He's like, can you play the video? And it's like, I got to sit back and relax for like 5 minutes. And the story was told pretty much.
Nice.
And but no, it's a great piece that we're going to use for marketing, obviously, so people and get a better idea what we're all about.
You and know? I'm not really sure how this works, but clearly the best part of it, you know, when they have that like preview picture on there.
Is yeah,
it's me, you, and Crowley.
Now, by the way, I just want to let you know, whenever I post anything, including the like the picture,
the photos, from the events.
I don't know what chooses the photo, but
I don't know how that works either.
But I don't know. So, anyways,
it finally froze on me.
Me, you, and Crowley were frozen on.
Yeah, so, I love that,
and that was great. I thought it was a great picture because, you know, what that video tried to portray is not just what we do, but you know, this is important, guys. We are a family. I mean, I really believe we are a family, and. I mean, as you can see with all the relationships that have built within Club 400, all you guys listening to this podcast right now, I know most of all our Club 400 members are listening to this one right now.
They better be.
We love you guys more than you love us, right, William?
We do love you more than you love us, for sure.
And we haven't
even had a t-shirt made. Oh,
we should.
They did already. Yeah.
So, I just wanted to point that out, guys, that, I mean, it's already working in small different ways. I won't get into, but, like, I'm using it. To like when I reach out to someone, hey, this is what we're all about. This is what we've done. Yeah. Blah blah blah. It's already working. So, I mean, honestly, I've asked you guys before, but if you could share that video, gets in one person's hands, it could change what we do.
And I'd like forever. To plug a plug,
William.
I'd like to plug a plug.
Please plug a plug.
I'd love it if you watched the video. If you haven't seen it yet, if you'd watch it on our new. Club 400. It's not new anymore. It's a few weeks old, but our new Club 400 podcast website.
Very usable. Is that was that a word, usable?
It's usable, yeah. It's the lead video on that page. It's got the purpose of that page, because there's a Club 400 page already that has other purposes. The purpose of this particular website is two things. Easy place to find our podcasts and videos.
Yes.
And that's the lead video because it's the newest. That's how they kind of get on there. And the other thing is you can sign up to get updates every time we do a new podcast. And there's, you know, 10 people that have signed up, but we need to get more.
Yeah,
and
can we have like 20 or 30?
There's going to be prizes at the end of the rainbow there, right? You know, we'll have some giveaways down the road.
We were just talking about it earlier, and this is not on the official talk about list, William.
Oh.
But I mean, seriously, here? Club 400, like, come on, guys. I mean, Justin Steele was at Club 400, and we only sold 64 tickets or whatever it was. Wow. And like, Justin Steele, come on now. I think I don't know about you, William, but I actually have, not kidding, not lying, went on Priceline and priced out tickets to Seattle. Because if my boy, you know, if he's going to Seattle, I'm going to Seattle. I'm going to hang out with his dad, Ben. I'll tell you that. Me and Ben are going to hang out, all right?
Could you explain to people what's happening in Seattle?
Oh, the 2023 All-Star Game.
What, All-Star?
And our boy Strosho has a really great shot if he keeps what he's doing to get there, too.
Amazing. So, it's amazing the effect that coming to Club 400 has on these Cubs, fine Cubs players, isn't it?
It really is. It really is. And I want to, breaking news. I got breaking news. William, don't you have something for that computer?
But I'm not going
to. See, he doesn't even know what button to hit, to be honest with you. Breaking news is our next podcast is being taken straight from the vault. Right, William?
Yes.
Tell him what's going on with our next podcast.
From the vault. Well, you know, we're all kind of excited about some of the recent call-ups from the Cubs organization. And the most recently is the King of Swing, the Rahm of Bomb, the, what else we got for him?
Club 400 alumni.
Club 400, Christopher Morel, Mr. Yes. Smile himself, who was here last year. We could not pinpoint the date at this point, but, you know, we'll get it for you later. Anyway, there's a Q&A from said party that has never been released. And since he's up and he's dominating, we thought, now would be a good time to release that into the wild.
And it's timeless.
And it'll be our first bilingual show.
Who's our host? Who did the Q&A, William?
Miguel. I can't say it with rolling my tongue.
Esperanza.
Esperanza.
Our friend.
I love Miguel.
We love him.
What a great guy. But that was a great Q&A.
Why have we held that back so long? What was the deal with that? Why hasn't that been released? Why are we sitting on that?
You know what? If anybody knows the answer to that question, hit us up on Facebook and let us know why we've been sitting on
it.
You know,
we've been sitting on it.
Here's the thing. We're a little bit like...
Is it because you're maybe not motivated to put it out?
No, I'm just asking you.
I'm not...
We're a little bit like we're a little bit like Prince, the musician. He has a vault.
It's a vault.
He has literally like three lifetimes of music in that vault, even though he's been passed away for several years. We've started a vault with some shows.
We have some vaults.
There's a few shows in that vault that are not going to get out anytime soon, but there's some shows in there, just so you know.
There's some shows.
Let me just put it to you this way. If this podcast ever ends, like we're done, this is our last show, there's always more, just so you know.
True story.
Hashtag the truth. I picked that up on Truth Social.
So anyways.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Where was I going next, William? I know where I was going next. I got it written down.
The Cubs' greatest fan of all time.
Well, yeah. I mean, perhaps. Honestly, guys, this wasn't planned. The last time I saw our great Dorothy Farrell was in 2020. During the pandemic, William, you were there, right?
We did a drive-by birthday party for her.
Yeah, it was a parade. It was in May in 2020.
Yeah.
And weird situation, obviously, to do a drive-by birthday party.
But, and that would have been her...
She's 97. She just turned 97.
So that was a few years ago.
So that was like, that's 94? Yeah, 94th birthday?
94th birthday, yeah.
I can do math, William.
You are good at math.
I'm not bad.
I was gonna call Lauren down here to run those numbers for us, but you got it.
So, yeah, our good friend, Jimmy LaFrancis, who I just talked to about being on our podcast very soon.
Oh, my God.
He said, I don't know if I'd be any good.
He'd be hilarious.
I mean, Jimmy will be awesome. We've got to get him on the podcast. We're going to do that at Club 400.
He's okay, the best bartender / clown ever.
Oh, he is. He's family to me.
Actually,
he
that really day is. At Dorothy's 94th birthday party, he was on stilts.
Yes, he was.
You cannot beat that. Jimmy LaFrancis on stilts.
You know, if you don't know who Jimmy is, which most of you do that listen to this podcast, he is a certified clown.
And
he works for Ringling Brothers Barnum & Bailey Circus.
And he's the best bartender ever.
And he is my, I don't know if I should say favorite. I have other bartenders that listen to this podcast.
Yeah, we have lots of favorite bartenders, but he pours.
Always make good friends with your bartender.
Have you ever had a non-Club 400 drink poured by Jimmy LaFrancis?
Well, I know Jimmy has his own drink called the Jimmy Drink.
Right. But has he ever poured you a non-Club 400 drink?
No.
For those of you who don't know, Club 400 drinks are a little bit stronger than regular drinks. Doubles, triples, you know. You know how that goes.
Yeah.
So who's this Dorothy Farrell
So Jimmy calls me up and he says, hey, we got this opportunity, her son... said we can stop by and we're going to do, you know, have food and hang out with her. So, you know, I was a little apprehensive. I mean, obviously I wanted to go and everything, but you know, Dorothy, she doesn't remember anything, you know? So she's at the worst stage of Alzheimer's disease. And man, and what a horrible disease. Like honestly, seeing Dorothy the other day, I got to put that cause on my list down the line. I really do. I mean, it's horrible because Dorothy, honestly, she's alive and well right now. She's alive and well. She just doesn't remember anything, you know. She's healthy. And you know what? She still has an appetite. And, you know, we had the right people around us that day. You know, I'm thankful my mom came. And, you know, Jimmy, like I said, Jimmy and Whitney and Debbie and Kathy came by. And it was really nice. And, you know, there's a couple moments that will always stick out to me, but hey, William, I want you to cue this up real quick. This is a clip that I shared with Dorothy as we were sitting on the couch, and I showed her the video, and I'll let you play it, and then I want to tell you what I felt her reaction was to it, okay?
Right.
Dorothy, seriously, 84 is when you got your tickets. Did you ever think this day would come?
No. I just wish my brothers were alive to see this. because I had a brother killed in the war, another brother prisoner in Germany for 21 months, and two other brothers overseas. And they loved the Cubs, and my father did too, but they're all dead now. And this old lady's still living.
You're still going. Now, how are you going to celebrate tonight?
Who knows? I probably have a Jägermeister.
All right, Dorothy, thank you very much. Enjoy it.
The great Ken Rosenthal.
Oh, my gosh. A moment.
I love how she says Jägermeister.
A moment I'll never forget. A moment that I was there for, yep, behind her. And anyways, I decide to play it for her. Just to see, you know, how she'd react to it. And I put it on, and I had her full attention. And she looked at it, and like, her eyes looked at it intensely, and she's like, "That's me." I go, "I know, Dorothy." I'm like, "I know." I'm like, "You're famous. I just want to let you know that you're a wonderful person." And then she looked at it, and then she was like, took her mind off it for an instance, and like, you know. But I want to tell you something. In that moment, we connected with. I feel honestly, I'm not just bullcrapping you, William. Like I told you before we did this podcast tonight, I feel like we connected with her. And like my mom said, we could have went there. Like Dorothy's not used to being around people, you know. And like we could have went there and it could have been a really bad experience. It wasn't a bad experience. It was a wonderful experience. You know, I got to see Dorothy smile. I got to see her sense of humor. Even though she didn't remember me and she didn't even remember her own brother who's taking care of her. Mm. But I saw Dorothy, and I was with Dorothy, even though I honestly believe like her heart knew we were there, and she responded to us with nothing but love. And it could have been different, you know, mm-hmm. Like you deal with some Alzheimer's patients that are angry or upset, you know, because they don't know what's going on, you know. I feel Dorothy's heart was there, and yeah, I feel like we connected with her that day. It was awesome.
And you took some video from it. Encounter, and your mom's just so good with her.
Oh yeah,
like your mom's a rock star.
And I'll tell you this, there's a few things that took place. One of them I was there for, one of them I had to skip out for because I actually had a meeting with the Special Olympics group at 2:00, but you know, I had to go see Dorothy, so Dorothy was number one priority, but it just kind of, I had to leave. But we did the YMCA for Dorothy, and Debbie Leviton was there, and she recorded it, and I'm going to get the video out there. And, you know, I said this on my post earlier on Facebook, you know, when YMCA comes on, it's usually when a pitcher from the opposite team gets pulled, you know, they play the YMCA, and I often look over at first base, hoping like somehow Dorothy will appear. Yeah. But I still like think about her. And she was so much of a part of the Cubs in the seventh inning stretch for so long and such a great, you know, fan. And you know, that's what we're all about. We're all about the fans and being able to get close to Dorothy and, you know, being friends with her. And she loved her Cubs, man. That's what she did. And she loved all the fans that would come up to her and say hello. Yeah, it was honestly a blessing to be able to do that, and it was something that I was wondering if I was worried I would regret, and I totally don't regret it. I was with the great, great people around me, and it was an extraordinary day. So we love Dorothy, and Dorothy loves you guys. I want to let you know that, guys. And you know, whenever we brought up the Cubs in Wrigley Field, she kind of perked up, William.
That's really awesome.
And we kept telling her, "You're famous, Dorothy. You're famous. Everybody loves you." You know, we tried to fill her with love, man. You know, make her feel loved. And yeah, and they sang "Happy Birthday" to her.
That's great. So, that's so cool.
Yeah, it was a nice day, and I wanted to share that with you guys. I wanted to share that with the Club 400 family because it was like I said, Alzheimer's is a terrible disease, and I got to see it firsthand. And you know what? We're going to do something down the line for all. And my good friend Dave Dew's mother went through it. And I know, you know, quite a few people that have dealt with it. So we got to make that one of our causes down the line for sure. You know, William, we are so excited. You know, Betsy Shepherd, you know Betsy.
Love Betsy.
Oh, my gosh.
Shout out to Betsy Shepherd.
Betsy's unbelievable. She loves her first responders, as do we do, and Club 400 does. And she's doing her annual.
We should have her on as a guest sometime.
Betsy. Oh, my gosh. She's hilarious.
And we'll ask her why she blocked us from going on the rooftop.
She is a basically, yeah, exactly. She is a Chicago socialite.
Socialite icon. I'd say
socialite. And,
that's a perfect word for her, socialite.
She's a socialite. She's famous. She really is. And she runs a Canal Shores golf outing every year, and it's an unbelievable event. And honestly, Club 400 is so proud to be a part of it. Not only are we a part of it, but the Salsa King is a part of it too.
Really?
Yeah. So, no, we're actually going to go to the party Sunday night. I think there's tickets available to go to the party. I think it's in Evanston. And then Saturday.
Joel Murray?
Joel Murray, Bill's brother. Unbelievable
Does
guy,
Bill
too.
Does Bill ever show up to that?
You know what? Here's the thing.
I know he's unpredictable.
He'll show up if, you know, whatever for a reason. They get mad at him because if they could advertise that Bill Murray was going to be at this thing, it would be sell out, you know.
Right.
But Bill just, he beats by his own drum.
I love that about him.
And basically, he might be there, he might not. But there's going to be a lot of people there. Jody Davis will be there, our good friend.
I really would like to meet Jody.
Ray Burris will be there.
Ray Bone.
Oh, my gosh. No, there's going to be a lot of great Chicago celebrities. Norm from Cheers is going to be there.
I love it.
Yeah. So, we are looking forward to that. Canal Shores, tickets are available. Look on our page. We do have a link if you want to come to the party on Sunday night. And like I said, it benefits first responders. There's tons of great sponsors. And me and Marty will be on the 13th hole giving away free cans of Club 400 Lager.
And
of
salsa.
Course, the Salsa King. Marty's going to be busy with me this weekend.
Do you guys
weekend.
Need anyone to carry your bags or anything?
No, I mean, I invited you, William. I invited you. Can you take off work Monday? I'm asking you to take off work early a few days. Like, we're going to the
Monday?
Cubs game. Yeah, this Monday. Can you take off?
No, I'm going to the game Tuesday.
I know, exactly.
No, I got something else Monday.
See?
I got a funeral.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
So sorry to hear that.
I don't want to go there.
All right, we won't go there. So, anyways, we're proud to be a part of it. Man, and I'll tell you what. We talked about this earlier. And one of my favorite things, William, is our newest program that we started last year, and honoring Cub fans. And today we picked our winner, man. And I'll tell you what, I wish when I made that phone call today to Brian Rose that you guys could have been there with me, because without you guys, this stuff is impossible.
You know, I would like to, somebody brought this up. I kind of agree with him. I'd like to call him, instead of a winner, an honoree.
Honoree. That's right. Not even a winner. Yeah, right.
Because
I like that, William. You're right.
Are we going to talk about Brian?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Okay, so Brian also called in the middle of our or texted you while we were podcasting.
Yeah, so before we came on air tonight, Brian, so you guys know, and for, you know, we had a lot of people write in, and we're going to try to accommodate as many as possible. Yeah. We might do 3 or 4 of these this year. Brian's our first winner, but I contacted him earlier today to let him know, and our good friend from Club 400, Dale Crater, he wrote in about him, and to be quite honest with you, I think it's beautiful because I didn't know it was Daryl that actually sent that request, and
really?
I didn't see that it was totally him.
Good. Okay,
but I read a story about his son Austin. They call him AJ, and it really touched my heart. And so I called him. Like I said, I wish all you guys could have been there. Like, we should have recorded that phone call. And so he got back to me this evening, and we called him right before this podcast. William, tell us a little bit about, like, what you got out of that conversation, because this is a great pick that we chose for a family, just to take him to a Cubs game for one day and just have a wonderful day at Wrigley Field.
Yeah, and the one thing, before I tell you what I got out of that call, because I will, but the one thing we were talking about, too, kind of offline is, you know, when we do stuff like the party we're going to be talking about that's coming up in August is for Special Olympics, which is phenomenal. I'm, like, so excited about that as the charity and all that. And we'll raise a ton of money, hopefully record-setting money.
We will break the all-time Club 400 record August 17th, Thursday at Club 400 with Joe Maddon.
And I know a lot, actually, about that organization, and I know they'll do amazing things with that money. But we don't really get to see end result of who that touches and what exactly happens. And that's okay. We don't need to, you know, like everybody who donates to that, we don't need that. I don't think anybody in Club 400 would say that's a big deal. But what's so great about this Honoring Cubs Fans program is that it's like one-on-one. Like, you get to see and know, and you've done some amazing videos of the experience and stuff, and that's, like, the coolest. That might be the coolest thing that, like, we do.
I think it is. I mean, I've written out checks, and I don't say I say we have written out checks for a lot of money. But, I mean, there's nothing better than, like, like Herbie last year, or Brian,
right,
and hanging out with that family, and then leaving that situation and say, wow, that was awesome, you know. You know, for, you know, 3 to 4 hours of that day, they forgot about life's problems, you know.
Right.
And that's what the whole thing about Club 400 was. Like, when I walked into Wrigley Field, I forgot about everything that I had to deal with in life. And for 3 to 4 hours, it was baseball, sunshine, beer and friends and nothing but love, you know. And that's the whole part of this program. That's why we do what we do here.
So our conversation with Brian that we had when he texted you and we stopped actually recording this podcast and, you know, hit pause and we talked to him, and I knew like a tiny bit about the story that you had told me, but then we talked to him and I'm like, oh my gosh, this sounds so familiar. Like, his son AJ is very... You have all the information on the name of the disease. I can't even pronounce it.
It's a neurological, actually, disease called, and I'm going to do my best to pronounce this, pontocerebral hypoplasia type 6.
I love when you try to pronounce things.
And I'm terrible at it. But if you want to look it up, you can look it up as PCH-6.
Yeah, and there's what, like 40 kids that are known that have
this. I'm just going to read this.
In the world, right?
If you can give me I will read this. I'm a pretty good reader, right, William?
Do you want me to read it?
No, I'm pretty good. But no, this is PCH6, kind of what the definition of it is. It says, and this is Daryl writing this to me, this disease is so rare that there are only 40 diagnosed cases worldwide, and limited research and funding exists to support his condition. PCH6 causes Austin to have seizures, physical delays, and then receive all of his nutrition, hydration, and medication through a G-tube. Because of Austin's complex medical needs, he needs a full-time nurse and is needed to help his family manage his ever-changing and challenging day-to-day needs. Fundraised through Austin's A-team will go directly to AJ's family to help pay for the cost of his full-time nursing care, as well as his equipment, home renovations, or other costs associated with his care and progress. Like, William, when I read this, right, I think about you, you know?
Well, I mean, it's a different disease name, but it's a carbon copy of what went on with my son, Charlie. And when we talked to Brian, I was like, oh my gosh, I can so relate to everything that you're going through every minute of every day. That's what you're doing. And he says they have full-time nursing, and you think, oh, you don't do anything because you got a full-time nurse. Guess what? Nurses, first of all, they don't work 24 hours a day ever. And second of all, they don't show up a lot of times. Like, you know, they get sick and stuff like that. So I can't tell you how many hundreds of times the night nurse would call us at 5 to 10, she's supposed to be there at 10, like, I can't make it, you know, there's too much snow. And so guess what? Then I got to stay up all night, you know, doing what she was going to do and stuff like that. And it's just, it's a constant, I mean, there's so much joy in it. I can't even begin to tell you, like, how much joy my son brought to me. But it's a constant 24-hour-a-day thing. If you're not with them, you're thinking about it. And we were talking actually about like the beeping machines. Charlie passed away 5 years ago. I still hear the machines beeping at night. I wake up in the middle of the night and I hear the feeding tube thing beeping, or the trach machine or whatever. So our stories were similar, not totally similar, but I can kind of relate a little bit to what they're going through. And, you know, the thing that's so great about this program is it's not just about AJ. I mean, it definitely is centered on him, but his mother, his father, his brother, I mean, those people deserve something like this too.
Oh yeah.
You know,
it's not all about AJ. It's about the family and creating a memory, an awesome memory.
And you know what it is? It's such a totally awesome memory, and that's what it is. And he said to us, you know what? Anytime we can get AJ to go out and do anything, it's such a great, awesome feeling, you know?
Right.
And that's the way we, you know, we felt with Charlie. And so, I mean, yeah, I can totally relate to this one. I mean, I've been able to kind of relate to all of them, but I can relate to this one very specifically, and so excited for
And we're bringing with you with us, William.
Well, yeah, that's the best part.
I might make you drive. I don't know.
I'll drive.
I usually make William drive, if you guys don't know that.
Well, make me drive home for sure, but that's not really part of our podcast tonight. We'll go into that on our next show maybe, but...
Oh, no. I mean...
This is a great program, and you know what? Keep the stories and the... applications coming in, and it really is. I feel very strongly. I know we've you know, struggled with what to call it and all that in the past. They're not winning anything.
It's honoring Cub fans. Honoring Cub people.
Being honored for what they're doing, because what they're doing is not normal. You know, it's not, when you're growing up and you're thinking about getting married and having kids and raising a family and stuff. That's not what you dream about, for sure, you know. But right. The fact that they're doing it, and you know what I told him when we were talking to him offline, which is, I don't know. I'm trying to figure out if I said the right thing or I regret saying it. But I said, you know, whatever you do, just make sure that you spend some time whenever you can, because you don't have – that's one thing you don't have is time. I said, make sure you spend time and focus on your wife. Because I cannot tell you, when you have somebody, a child that's in kind of that boat, you connect with other people that are similar, you hear stories or whatever. So many people, it breaks up marriages because it's just so taxing on both parents.
And you know more than anybody. I mean, you've been through it, man.
And, yeah, and fortunately, you know, my wife wouldn't leave me, but she probably should have 10,000 times.
I would have left you many times.
For sure. So would anyone. But again, neither here nor there. Just super excited about this and how great the program is and all that.
Yeah. We spoke with Brian earlier. He's a school teacher with CPS, and he's the basketball coach at Ridgewood High School and head coach of his son's Collins team. So.
And we did a shout-out to Daryl.
Oh, yeah, Daryl Crater, obviously. Right.
Great.
And I chose this without knowing that Daryl nominated him. So
that's great.
I talked, you know, better. I spoke with Debbie, and I said, what'd you think about this one? You know, and I was like, I love that one. I said, let's do it.
Yeah.
So we're going to do more. This is our first one of the year, and like I said, I'm so honored to be able to do it, and it's because of you guys. And by the way, Brian has been complaining to Daryl that he can't watch any Cup games.
I know.
Because he doesn't get the marquee network. So, like we said, this is not just about AJ. It's about his entire family. Right. Like, we're going to be putting we're going to be sharing the GoFundMe page out there, but we're also going to do a FUBU 4-month subscription so his father can watch Cub games on the marquee network.
How do I get
Pretty
in
cool,
on
huh?
How do I get in on that? I need a
FUBU. I know, because you're a YouTube TV guy, right, William?
I am, and I'm doing the radio thing this year.
Oh, so you're Pat Hughes' guy, right?
Either that or I come over. Yeah, I'm Pat Hughes and Coom Dog.
Jeez.
Ron Coomer.
I tell you what, we love Ron Coomer. More about Ron Coomer later.
About the Coom Dog.
Honoring Cub fans, so happy to choose our first participant. Cub fans helping Cub fans. Without you, we can't do anything. So
got that right.
And we appreciate every one of you guys. And I just wanted to talk before we get in, you know, because we're here tonight because we have big news. Like, if you tuned in, I just want to let you know, if you tuned in to hear all the details of the Joe Maddon party here at Club 400 on August 17th. Time is 6:00 till 10:00. The main beneficiary is Special Olympics Illinois.
If you tuned in for that, you tuned into the right show.
Yeah, because I'm not going to let you down.
It's coming.
I'm not going to let you down, all right?
But you got to keep listening.
Yeah, and you know what? By the way.
Should we pause right now so
yes, we should.
People can go grab a cocktail?
Can we do a shot?
Yeah,
beer and a shot. It's beer and a shot night.
Yeah,
all right.
Sure.
Can you put, William, I thought you had all these clips.
Oh, yeah.
Can you play a clip here?
I can, yeah.
Here we go.
Hold on. You want to do a beer and a shot clip? That one?
Yeah, just choose that one. I'm going to let you choose. You're the director.
Club 400 Ballpark Lager is a beer for all nine innings. Take me out to the ball game. This crisp, easy drinking lager is perfect for a summer day amongst the bricks and ivy. Crafted at Crystal Lake Brewing, this beer is clean and refreshing with minimal bitterness so that you can celebrate a W in style. From Club 400, Cubs fans helping Cub fans, this baseball brew can be found at most places that sell beer in Northwest Illinois or from Crystal Lake Brewing. Beer master Ryan Clooney. Enjoy a beer or six pack today, and please remember to drink responsibly.
Boom.
Rod's Heroes. Let's talk about them real quick. Right. 7,200 raised from the Justin Steele event. We're going to be out there. I want you guys, if you're going to be in town, Monday, May 28th, Memorial Day, the founder's son is going to throw out the first pitch.
That's awesome.
And there's a little talk. Maybe we'll have some kind of event going on. I don't know if it's going to happen, but we're working on something. But Rod's Heroes was, I'll tell you what, William, one of the greatest things about Club 400, well, I mean, obviously a program like honoring Cub fans, but writing checks out. I mean, there's nothing better than that. Every time I write out any check, I think about all you guys that helped it make.
What's more pleasurable, writing the check out or handing the check to the person?
Usually it's mailed, to be quite honest with you. Yeah,
so. licking the stamp, it's not that glamorous.
But I will tell you this, Rod's Heroes, I know what they stand for, but I don't know much about them. But me and you are going out there.
Yeah.
And we're going to meet them, and we're going to do a quick photo. And I hope to work with them in the future. They pretty much tie in what we're doing with Special Olympics. And as far as honoring Cub fan program, they help. William, tell us a little bit what Rod's Heroes does.
Well, they basically help people adopt kids with special needs.
Right.
Which again, is in my wheelhouse. Like, how are you finding all these people?
I don't know. I think they're just, I know, It's meant to be.
I don't know a ton more than that, but we're definitely going to find out some more, and I'm very much looking forward to them. And they were talking about
maybe doing an article with you.
They're so appreciative of the money that was raised. They, like, couldn't believe it. So
and that's all because of Justin Steele and Libby and his family.
Yeah.
And obviously, we are big Justin Steele fans here at Club 400, and he's kicking some major butt. And we'll talk about him a little bit more later in the show.
Yes, we will.
But I did want to point out one more thing. I think it was May 6th. We went to the Kerry Wood event, the Pitch-In program, which was formerly the Kerry Wood Foundation. I think they renamed it. And we had a great time there. Me, Marty, Crowley, Bill Watts went. And guess who won the Bill Watts Fly the W? Kerry Wood, 20 strikeout game, wouldn't sign.
I don't know. It was beautiful, though, when I saw it on Facebook being made. I'm going to guess you.
I won the sign, William. Well, I'll say Club 400 won the sign.
Right.
So, real quick, I went up to Marty.
Are you going
to
re-gift that?
I mean, honestly.
Like auction?
I think it might be in the Maddon auction. Really? So.
Are you tempted, though, to hang it up?
Like, well, I'm only tempted because this is pretty much what happened when we it was in the Cubs Towers, we'll say, Ricketts office building overlooking Gallagher Way. You had to go up the elevator. You had to go in the main door there. And then you went up to the sixth floor. And I don't know if you a lot of you guys probably haven't been up there, but they built a nice bar area up there with a beautiful balcony overlooking Gallagher Way. And not only that, you can even go on the Waveland side a little bit. And beautiful cocktail hour. As soon as we got up the elevator, Kerry Wood was there to greet us. Mm. Let me tell you guys. And I told Kerry and Sarah this that night. I said, Kerry, because, they're doing their own things. They have their own lives and everything like that. But I said, Kerry and Sarah, do you realize that you, first of all, you were the first player ever at Club 400? And since you came and visit us, we have raised $765,000. They could not believe that, William. They had no clue, man.
Do you realize that you and I went to the Kerry Wood event 2 or 3 years?
We've been to a couple of them.
I know at least two.
We went to John Lester event. Remember that one?
Oh, yeah. But the Kerry Wood event, Kerry Wood is, I've thought long and hard about it. I've got three favorite all-time Cubs, and Kerry Wood is one of the three. And all I wanted to do was meet him, shake his hand, or whatever. You couldn't make that happen in those events.
Oh, I mean, honestly, you got your picture with him. Remember that?
I didn't.
That was a skinny picture of you,
no,
William.
I did get a picture with him.
Are you kidding me? No. At the Kerrywood event, you did not get a picture.
No, I did not.
I'm going to find it. It's out there. No, you got a picture of Kerry
no
Wood.
Picture of Kerry Wood.
The Wood. Are you kidding me?
Oh, you know what? If you're going to count the one where he's standing behind the
yes,
wall,
exactly. Yeah, okay, all right, all right.
You
busted.
Know, that's as close as I got. I was like 20 feet away.
But honestly, Kerry Wood.
I do have a good picture with Bonnie Hunt from that.
Oh, yeah.
Event.
I got her number on my phone. I forgot about that.
Bonnie Hunt.
We got to get Bonnie. We should get Bonnie Hunt out here for Maddon. I think
awesome,
she loves Maddon. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to write that down. Now I'm writing notes from our show.
Call Bonnie Hunt.
To come to Club 400.
Did you get her digits
August
that night
17th.
Or no?
I got her digits.
I know
it's
you
in
got
my
a,
phone.
I know you got a bunch of digits.
I got there, a lot of digits in my phone. Anyway. I call you more than anybody, William. So in conclusion, Kerrywood, I mean, unbelievable chair. They run one of our first players ever at Club 400. But what they do is they have a mentorship program, and they take kids from like third grade all the way through to get all the way through college, and they mentor these kids, make sure they get on the right path, and they work, inner city youth neighborhoods. And what they do is simply amazing and inspirational. And I've always been really proud to work with the Kerrywood Foundation, now called the Pitch In Program. And going forward, like I told those guys, you guys are part of us, we're a part of you. And, like I said, only great things ahead for what they're doing. And I want Kerrywood. I told them, I said, William. Kerry, you were out in like, I think it was 2015. I could be wrong. It's time for you to come back to Club 400, man.
Absolutely.
It's time for Kerrywood to make, you know what? Because back then we had a whole different crowd than we have now.
Our regular,
yeah, you didn't know me. A lot of the regulars weren't here when Kerrywood came here.
Right.
So I say we bring Kerrywood back. This is what I say. I'm propositioning it to you right now. Okay.
Oh, I'm in.
100-person party.
There you go.
All right. Just like Justin Steele party. Real small. Kerrywood. Get a Sarah. Get his family out here. We'll split proceeds 50-50. 50% to the pitching program. 50% to Club 400. Because that's the thing, William, I did want to talk about before we get into the big announcements. Is like, you know, we are a charity ourselves. But I can't tell you how many times we give stuff to other people too, but we need funds, guys. We really do. So, I mean,
so many opportunities to sponsor.
Yeah, I mean,
like the events and stuff like that. And here's the thing: like, I know you got a new list coming out of the different sponsorship levels.
Yeah, we're gonna talk about that.
But you know what? Guess what? If you look at that list and you're like, I can't afford $1,000 or whatever, my company can't do that or whatever. We'll take $250. We'll take $500.
We'll take anything, guys.
We'll take anything. Anything, any dollar that you can that you can send is going to go straight to whatever the charity is. There's no money made by anybody in this organization, and it's all about Cubs fans helping Cubs fans.
Yeah, and like, for instance, someone that has recently followed us, Blake Beard, man, he donated like 4 games worth of tickets. I promise you, those tickets are going to go to the right places. Yeah. We're going to get people, like, even though, like, Brian, we chose him as our first, but I'm going to go through those lists and just see people who might need 2 tickets to a game.
We got another guy, good friend of ours up in Wisconsin, Mike Gomel, who's donating stuff. We're not going to talk about that
tonight. We're not going to talk about it yet, but Mike Gomel, our friend, unbelievable. We're meeting him Tuesday night. We'll be at the game Tuesday night, William.
We'll get some deets on what he's donating, but that's going to be a game changer.
Joey Song, which fights autism. Yeah. We've talked about it in the past.
Yeah,
unbelievable
we
charity.
Are definitely going to make that a Club 400 event next year. I mean, we've run into COVID and some other stuff, but I know you went up there, but we got to get a busload.
Definitely. So, I mean, William, do you have like one more like commercial we could play?
I do. Would you like to hear that?
Yeah. And then we're going right now next to the Joe Maddon event, okay? But we're going to give one of our good friends here a prop here. Stacy just got fired
again.
Are you looking for something that is completely unique for your home, business, or event? Amanda at Letters from Elliot offers one-of-a-kind items that are highlighted with hand-lettered calligraphy and illustration. Whether you are looking for wedding or event items with a personal touch, gifts that are engraved, or a business logo, Letters from Elliot creates designs for nearly any occasion, specializing in event and commercial signage as well as hand engraving. For more information, go to lettersfromelliot.com. That is Elliot with two L's and two T's.
We are here on a very important day. It's my pleasure to introduce the manager of the Chicago Cubs, Joe Maddon.
This is a one in 107-year opportunity for me right now.
Please welcome the manager, number 70, Joe Maddon.
We're going to set our mark high. In my mind's eye, we're going to make the playoffs next year.
For the first time in 12 years, the Chicago Cubs have a postseason victory.
And the 0-2.
Swing and a miss. Cubs win. Cubs win. Cubs win.
Swing and a miss. Cubs win.
The Cubs are going to the World Series.
My first thought is we did not suck.
Four more, we could really have a party.
A little bouncer slowly toward Bryant. He will glove it, throw to Rizzo. It's in time. The longest drought in the history of American sports is over, and the celebration begins.
Don't ever permit the pressure to exceed the pleasure.
Joe Maddon brings out the gloves, and here we go.
The best manager in Cubs history. He changed the franchise forever.
Club 400 is proud to introduce the newest member of the Club 400 family, the 2016 World Series champion manager for Chicago Cubs, Joe Maddon.
It's so cool.
Unbelievable. Joe Maddon is coming to Club 400. Are you ready, William?
I am so ready.
And we got all the details here tonight, man. We're going to share everything with you guys. And since you guys listen to our podcast, you are going to be the first people to be able to get tickets first. That means first in line privileges.
That means we need to come up with a code word.
I have a code.
Oh, you have the
oh,
code?
Oh, we have a code. Come on, William. What do you think? I did this yesterday or what?
Oh, it's not your first round.
I have passcode here. All right. So Club 400 presents a night that won't suck. Thursday, August 17th. That's a Thursday, 6 o'clock till who knows when.
Yeah, I've already talked to a few people that took Friday off. Yes, you should. It's a national.
And the Cubs actually have a 120 game the next day.
Perfect.
We did that on purpose.
Yes.
So actually, we when we picked this date, it was for a current player because it made sense.
Right.
And you know what? To be quite honest with you, behind the scenes talk. And by the way, real quick, before I even get started with it, to do an event with Special Olympics means the world to me. They're such a first-class organization. And the people that I've met through Special Olympics, Brian Weymouth, who is a friend of mine, and Dave Breen, who runs Special Olympics, I mean, they make me really want to kick some butt on this event. Like I said, truth of the matter is, I said it earlier, I'll say it again, Our most amount of money we ever raised out of this basement in one single night was $66,000 for the Anthony Rizzo Foundation. I promise you guys, we're going to blow that out of the water. All right?
We're shooting for a record.
We're shooting for a record. And we have an unbelievable evening planned for you. And I'm going to tell you what, tickets are $200. Okay. And the goal is this, guys. We have sponsorship packages, which I'll talk about in a little bit. But I think the plan of attack is that every single dollar of your $200 that you pay to walk into a great party that you're going to have an unbelievable time is going to go to Special Olympics. And we're going to do that with the help of sponsors, William. We're going to do that help with our friends like Jeff Vukovich from Nationwide Insurance. Do you have anything queued up for him, William?
Well, fans, don't forget to check out the Blackhawks blog at WGNTV.
Need more drinks.
Well, fans, don't forget to check out the Blackhawks blog at WGNTV.com. What a great picture that was. Presented by Nationwide's Jeff Vukovich. Go to JeffVuk.com or follow him on social media. I heard he's like a real rock star on social media. Nationwide
is on your side. Everybody, I want to let you know, the number for Jeff Vukovich, Nationwide Insurance, they're out of Park Ridge, man. And they insure my basement. They insure Club 4 in Chicago. It's 847-825-4783. Ask for Michelle.
Is Vuk coming to the party?
Vuk will be at the party.
He's such a great guy.
He's the best. We love Jeff Vuk.
We get to hang out with him at a Cubs game.
Oh, he invites us up to the skyboxes. We have a great time, and I'm really proud that he was our first sponsor to jump on. And I want to let everybody know that if you have any car insurance needs or home, he's auto the man. Like, yeah. I trust him with this place. Yeah. You can trust him with your place. I promise you. So anyways, I think one of the big things we want to announce is, like, you know, a party needs, like, a host, right? And I can't always be the host, William, because I got to run the party.
So. I mean, you are the hostess with the mostest, but...
So I want to introduce the main man, our MC. And, William, when you do a party, man, you got to have someone, right? Someone that could rock the mic.
Somebody who's like an MC, the MC with the mostest.
So someone who is, you know, charming, funny. He's got, I mean, he's kind of good looking, don't you think, or no?
Oh, yeah. Somebody who's comfortable behind the mic. I mean, I know you are. We mock you every part you're at when you get the mic, but you're comfortable with the mic.
I'm pretty
right?
comfortable with the mic, yeah.
You need somebody comfortable with the mic.
Yeah, someone who actually makes sense. So, I mean, I wanted to hire the best, man. I wanted to hire.
Oh, he is the best.
And you know what? This event is family. Like I said earlier, the Special Olympics, the group of the people, they're family. I've been hanging them out with 3 years. We've been hanging out 3 years. And we're finally doing an event together, and I'm so happy. So.
And how long ago did we meet this guy?
Joe, we met. Well, first of all, Joe. By the way, everybody.
Oh, Joe's on
Club
the phone?
400 MC Joe Maddon, our good friend and your favorite Chicago comedian. I mean, favorite comedian ever, Joe Kilgallen. We got him on the line. Joe, what is up, my brother?
What is up, Sir William? Sir Stewart, I'm going to call you a sir.
That's
too,
fine.
He's the Duke.
He's the Duke. Duke, I like that.
Well, you know, like Duke, we were in Iowa. To see the Iowa Cubs opening day earlier this year.
The story's coming out, huh?
Not that one.
Okay.
And in the group that we had Sir William, we have the Salsa King of Chicago, and we're like, we got to come up with a nickname for Stu, you know, like royalty. He's the Duke.
The Duke's a good one. You had Salsa King, Sir William, Duke, and just plain old Crawley.
And Crawley.
Yeah, Crawley. Yeah.
And Crawley. Anyway, we met you at Parkside. What was that, a year ago, 2 years
Dude,
ago?
I mean,
I want to say it was 2 seasons ago.
No, I met Joe Kilgallen before Joe Kilgallen met me, okay? Kilgallen. It was the Anthony Rizzo Laugh Off Show.
Okay.
And this one was not even open to the public, right? I think John Hendricks
got event.
Yeah, private event, right? Guess who got in at a private event, huh, William?
You
huh?
Did?
Yeah, I mean, I think I know a few people, right?
Yeah.
And here I see this guy up on the stage interacting with all these cup players. You brought them all on stage. You did a bunch of cool stuff, man. It was like the highlight of the show, but Joe killed it that night. I know Joe knows he killed it that night, so tell us a little bit about that, Joe. That was pretty cool, huh? Being a Cub fan and being involved with that.
Oh, that was incredible. Yeah, that was fantastic, being a lifelong Cubs fan. And then being asked to perform at the time, my favorite Cub, Anthony Rizzo's Laugh Off for Cancer event in front of all the Cubs. It was amazing. What I love, though, is now I get to tell a story from that event that ties into the big guest you got coming up here. So Anthony Rizzo told the comedians, hey, feel free to roast us a little bit, because I guess Anthony's a big fan of a lot of the Comedy Central roasts. So if you want to go at us, make fun of us a little bit, we're game, do it. I'm like, all right. So I did a few jokes. You know, I talked about Schwarber a little bit, because remember, he had just lost a bunch of weight. And people were like, is the power going to go away? And then people were like, can he play left field? He doesn't really have a glove. And some of the other comedians made jokes about how he's a bad defensive player. So I said, hey, Schwarber, if anyone makes fun of you for having a bad defensive war and all that kind of stuff, your defensive stats are bad, I want you to tell them, suck my D, I hit 412 in the World Series. So that got a big.
Nice.
I tried to keep it clean for your podcast, I didn't swear.
I don't know why, because we don't. But
so
what's that, Dick?
That was a big one. Yeah, Dick.
Dick.
Okay. Right. Dick, everybody.
Dick.
You heard that, kids? Dick.
I'm sorry, Stu's mom. We said Dick.
I do get yelled at for swears, wife. Just so you know.
Dick is technically not a swear word.
Technically, it's not. It's a person's name.
It's not one of George Carlin's like eight words you can't say on the podcast, right? And that was radio, too. So,
yeah, that was radio and TV. So podcast itself, it's a free-for-all.
It's a free-for-all.
But then I segued over to talking about Joe Maddon, because Joe Maddon was there. And what I said was, I was kind of working my way around the room, bringing up each player, you know? And I was like, oh, wait, where? I've noticed I haven't seen Kyle Hendricks. Is Kyle here, or did Joe send him home early? Did you send him home early, Joe?
I remember that. Dude, he killed it. That's when I met Joe. Because I'm like, that guy just killed it. I don't even know who this guy is. But the Rizzo Foundation did a good job by hiring this guy. Yeah. I'm like thinking, I got to meet this guy one day.
Yeah, no, and
he was hanging out with the big boys that night. He had no time for someone like me.
I would have gladly talked to you. But I did meet Tom Ricketts that night. I had a great conversation with him before the game. And I know Tom Ricketts is a friend of Club 400.
He might show up to the event, by the way. I said might, but he might. He's an off night for him. We'll see.
Never know.
It all depends on is he buddies with Joe? I don't know. But go ahead.
Yeah, that'd be an interesting thing to find out. So that night, before the event started, I was talking to Ricketts, which was interesting about Tom. I'll give him credit. He's a very punctual guy, because he showed up like very early before everybody else. And, people were kind of talking a little bit. So I talked to him a little bit. You know, this was before the 2018 season. And then I said to him, I go, oh, is the rumor about like a Cubs TV network? Is that going to happen? Talking about Marquee. And he goes, yeah, that seems to be the what's going to happen. I'm a little bit worried, though, about filling content. And I'm like, well, if you need a handsome comedian to talk Cubs, I'm your guy. And he said, all right, I'll think about it. You know, we were kind of joking with each other. And then when I got off stage, I walked right by him going, how'd you like that? But I haven't heard from him, so I don't know if he liked it too much.
No, I mean,
a little awesome. Too filthy.
Real quick, like, I mean, between me, you, and everybody listening to this podcast, when you got off the stage at the night, because I knew, I'm like, that guy was great, because it was funny. It was awesome. Did you know you killed it that night? Was that a night when you went home and you're like, yeah, I'm going to drink an extra shot tonight or something? I mean.
Oh, definitely. Well, yeah. I definitely knew that, because I felt like, you know, as stand-up comedians, we have a little more control of the room. And I was following a couple improvisers who did some funny stuff. But it's just like, as a stand-up, you could just grab the mic and be like, hey, I'm talking right to you. Or improvisers are trying to create like a scene and, you know, do that kind of thing. So once I got everyone's attention, I knew I had them. And then when the event was over, I was like, I got to get some pictures with these guys. But I wanted to play it cool. And luckily, when I went up to like them, I remember going up to Brian first, because he was right there. And he was like, dude, you're hilarious. And he gave me like that bro hug thing, you know, when you bring him in for a hug. And I'm like, okay, I just had an MVP tell me I was hilarious. So, yeah, I'm walking on air right now.
That's awesome.
I'm pretty good. It was an amazing night, amazing event. And then thankfully, it, you know, led me to Club 400, where we get to do more amazing events with amazing people.
Oh,
I could say amazing one more time.
Yeah, you could probably fit one in one more. Yeah. No.
One more. So, but what I loved about Joe Maddon was he had a great sense of humor about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. He was friends with some comedians, Mike Borzello, the Cubs old catching coach, who I think they missed.
So he took that joke. Okay. He liked that one.
Yeah, no, he liked the joke about sending Hendricks home early, because he was friends with this guy, Brody Stevens, who was really good friends with Mike Borzello. Brody sadly passed away just before the 2019
season. Right, R.I.P. Brody, man. You know, he meant a lot to you guys. I never got to meet him, but he's awesome. I'm glad we brought him up.
Great friends with him, too.
Yep, Pleacher Jeff.
And so Joe Maddon was talking about doing some, like, maybe stand-up at spring training to bring me and Brody out, but then sadly Brody passed away, and so we didn't get to do it. But the Cubs honored Brody by making those Brody shirts that Maddon designed. So I'm hoping, I still have mine. I wish it was in better condition, but I've worn it a lot. So I'm hoping to bring it to the event.
You sneak in, we'll get it taken care of for you for sure, buddy.
Yeah, I don't even care if he signs. I just want Joe to see it that way. I want to thank Joe for honoring my friend the way he did, and that's just the kind of guy Joe Maddon is. He's a dude who you can tell genuinely cares about people, and that's why he was the perfect manager for the Cubs winning a World Series. I mean, yeah, there's been talks here or there about, like, you know, certain decisions and all that, but the key was this, and I really want to emphasize this for your great listeners. It's that the Cubs always had this cloud over their head. Remember in 2008 when we went down in Game 1? It felt like that's it. That's the series, right? Yep. And it was like, no, it's only Game 1. But even in Game 7 of the World Series, I remember Javier Baez, who was the best defensive player I ever saw that season. He had two errors. And yet I was still confident that those errors weren't going to be the highlight I was going to see the rest of my life. You know, because Maddon created an atmosphere where it's like, oh, you made an error? Big deal. Who cares? Let's go back to work. Where other Cubs teams, they felt that pressure. They made an error. They felt like, oh, crap, that's going to be the new moment. That's the ball between Buckner's legs or Leon Durham's legs. That's the display. Like, you know what I mean? But Maddon kept that loose, chill atmosphere that made it so that the Cubs could bounce back from plays like that.
100%. I mean, he changed the culture, kind of.
No doubt.
He did, yeah.
He did. You know, I think, you know, he was the perfect guy for that team. And
he really was.
And, you know, I always remember Brace the Target. I mean, I just saw him in Arizona. We went to the Special Olympics that been out at Joe Davies' house, which Joe Davies, I believe, is coming to Club 400 on August 17th, William. And I'm happy to welcome him in my house. He's welcomed me into his a few times. But Joe spoke that night, and I'm telling you what, he killed it. Like, I think I said on a previous podcast, my wife was actually taking notes and writing stuff down, like texting herself what he said. But Joe's going to be awesome, you know. He's going to be unbelievable. And I'm really happy to, you know, have him out here. But more importantly, I'm happy to have Joe for fucking – did I say – you're going to have to beep that out. Oh, shit.
we'll leave the shit in there. But no.
But I'm really happy we got you, Joe, for
happy you asked me. I'm honored. Thank you.
And you are a part of Club 400. And, you know, we're behind it all. We're friends, man. I know you were sick for a while there, and we're looking forward to seeing you out at Wrigley Field and looking forward to seeing you at Club 400 Chicago really soon. Man,
so
yeah, man, I'm back to 100%, and yeah, let's hang, let's grab some beers.
So Joe is the answer to a Club 400 podcast trivia question.
Ooh, I like this.
You ready for this?
Yep.
Stu,
yeah.
So a little precursor, you know, I think to be an effective podcast or radio show or anything like that, you can't have dead air, right? So you need to have people that talk, you know, and stuff like that. Stu and I struggle because we both want to talk at the same time all the time. There's never dead air. It's the opposite, if anything else. But we've had two guests on our show over, what are we, you said 120? 100,
over, yeah, something like that.
110, 120 shows. We've had two guests where we could just shut our mics off and let those guests go. Big clue, one of them's Joe.
I'm flattered.
Well, wait till you hear who you're in rare air with. You know who the other one was?
No.
Probably show four.
Show four.
Very early on. Actually, not
Pink
done.
Pink Hat Guy?
Not done here, done at the radio station.
Pink Hat Guy?
No.
Four.
Legend. Chicago legend.
Dorothy?
Mike North.
Oh, Mike North, yes.
Remember Mike
not
North?
Surprised. I remember Mike.
Oh, God.
Monsters the Midway.
Hot dog stand.
Yeah, it was like Mike started talking, and Stu and I just kind of sat there, like, twiddling our thumbs, going, what the? And it was the same thing at Parkside when we had you on the show. I was like, oh, my God, this guy's so knowledgeable, so funny, such a great personality, so awesome. And then we got to know you, and you're really all that.
Yeah, I let you down. No, I'm
you're all that. And I speaking of letting you down, I got to apologize personally for my part in the not having us go up to Minnesota to watch the home run fest up there. But I was mostly looking forward to your show. I had a place lined up. Place my buddy owns
it's all good. We'll make it work next
we'll do
time.
It yeah no yeah. We'll definitely
it's Mother's
do it.
Day weekend. I think her probably
that,
lot.
Yeah, yeah, her a lot.
That's where that was the problem. Yeah, we got all on our mothers and wives and whatnot.
Joe, real quick,
we
you know,
got some bullets too up there, didn't we? It was not the best series for her.
No, we saved a lot of money, all of us did, by not going.
Yes.
But Joe, as you know, Club 400 is a family, and as you know, when you've played at certain gigs, even in Arizona when you're out in Phoenix. I think you played in Chandler, right?
I did.
A bunch of club 400 people showed up.
That wouldn't have happened without them.
Oh, man, it's unbelievable. But tell us, tell everybody what's coming up on your slate right now. Where are you playing? What do you want to promote right now? Because obviously we should get another outing and go see him, right, William? Oh, we should do that for sure.
Well, I'm all over Chicago, so you can see me at the Laugh Factory. I'm there a lot in the next 2 months. I'm also going to be, I know we might have some South Bend fans, I'm going to be headlining the Drop Comedy Club in South Bend, Indiana, June 9th and 10th.
Oh, are the Cubs? We should do that.
Are the Cubs in town?
I think they are going to be in town, but unfortunately they're playing at the same time I'm performing. They might have a day game that Sunday, perhaps. Yeah. So I'm going to be there as well. And then if they want, I have a new special coming out. We're ironing out the final details. It's been a little bit of a long process, unfortunately, but it's great, and I'm very excited for everyone to see it. So if they just want to follow me on YouTube in the meantime, I have hours of stand-up comedy content on there. Just type Joe Kilgallen into your YouTube search, and I'll pop up, and you could subscribe to the channel and enjoy yourselves. Thank you.
We could do a watch party here for when you release it, man. Just let you know. We'll do that. That'd be awesome. Yeah, we'll talk about that. Right? Yeah, that'd be cool.
Yeah, dude. Great idea.
Hey, I have one last question for you. Stu might have one too, but I got one last one. Your favorite comedian and your favorite Cubs player. Go.
Comedian. That's a tough one. Ooh. There's a lot of great ones. I'm going to go with Bill Burr.
Bill Burr, he's awesome.
He's great.
He's been my favorite of like modern, like right now, all time. I'd probably have to go with Carlin, you know. He's such a legend and really shaped a lot of what every comedian has done since. It's kind of like the Beatles of comedy. You know, there's inspiration. Everyone you see today has some inspiration from him. You could trace back to him. And then favorite Cub player, I will give you all time. It's a tie between Andre Dawson and Anthony Rizzo.
Nice.
Kerry Wood's up there, too. I'm a huge Kerry Wood guy.
Oh, we love Kerry, man. We just saw him. Yeah. I love Kerry. By the way, we're having a one-of-a-kind Fly the W. I think we're putting up there. I really want it, but... You know, I think we're going to auction it off at the Mad Event. That's an unbelievable sign. He signed We Got Wood on there, William.
Did he really?
Yeah. Nice. It was pretty cool, man. So, yeah, we saw Kerry Wood. He's doing great, by the way. Him and his family. Unbelievable.
That's awesome. Great guy.
But, yeah, Joe, we love you, man. We're really looking forward for you to come out and be a part of this and help us on our goal to raising $1 million. And, Joe, you are one of the reasons why we have raised $1 million. And, it's a pleasure to know you as your friend and, more importantly, helping us raise money for charity. And I couldn't ask for anybody better than this guy, right, Will?
You could not.
Joe Kilgallen, everybody. He's the best.
Thank you both. Love you guys. Club 400 for life. All right. Cheers.
All right. Take care.
Baseball's America's pastime.
Baseball.
You're listening to Club 400 Podcast, a show about Cubs fans for Cubs fans. Be sure to follow us on social media. We're active on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
So, William, you know what we do when we start a Club 400 party off, right?
We do.
I mean, we obviously...
I know what we do.
When we have a Club 400 party, it's like going to a baseball game, right?
Right.
So I brought someone in I thought was very special, and he is a special guy to us. He's been on our podcast before, and a great friend of Club 400. And so, can you play the clip, William?
We love you guys. Here we go.
Hi, my name is John Vincent.
I'm the anthem singer for the Cubs. The police said, "Hey, Johnny, what do you think about singing and making some people happy?" And I said, "Let's do that."
Man, there's people in here who are suffering, and we've got to help them.
This is my kind of town. Chicago is my kind of town. Chicago.
Music comes from our soul, because every time we think of music, we have music, we think of a specific time, good or bad, in our life, and it gives us comfort.
It's my kind of town.
My kind of town, because obviously this is our kind of town, residents here in Chicago.
I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Then what a wonderful world, always something. I think that just shows the beauty of nature, the beauty of mankind.
Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above.
And then God bless America, to paramedics, to nurses, to doctors, to people working at grocery stores, people working and doing things that are keeping things semi-normal for us and helping us and putting their lives on the line. That means a lot.
Sweet home!
Johnny Vincent coming to Club 400.
So if you can make people happy, that's what's important in life.
That's exactly right, John.
And this and that, and they might, but what are you going to do? Especially a time like this.
So I do need to tell you one thing about that clip of Mr. Vincent. You know, we've heard him sing multiple times. This is from a video that was shot during COVID. He went around to senior living places. I don't know if it was assisted living or whatever it was. Went out in the street, set up a microphone, and just started singing to the people. They were opening their windows and stuff. People were stuck inside with COVID. Families not visiting. You know, we were miserable as 50-year-olds. You're not 50 yet, but whatever.
I'm almost there.
You're almost there. But, you know,
we're going to have a big party at Wrigley Field, I think.
Is
somewhere.
It Wrigley Field,
I don't
or
know where.
Going to Vegas.
September 7th.
We're going to
it
Vegas.
Might be September 9th, okay. 10th, whatever.
So, long story short here, you know, we're, you know, fairly young. These are people that have been, like, stuck in a building for maybe a year and a half or whatever. Nobody visiting them. You know, people being sick all around them, all this and that. And then here comes this, you know, angelic voice from nowhere. That was just so cool, you know? I saw that video. It made me, like, tear up a little bit. I got to be honest.
I'll tell you what. I'm really proud of what we do with this podcast, William, but I don't know if you remember when we did the podcast with John Vincent.
Oh, God, it was one of the best.
Yeah, so if you ever want to listen to a really great podcast, yeah, go back in our, you know.
That's funny you say that, because if you look back, we've laughed, we've cried, you know.
We've done it all here.
There's been a lot. I mean, we've had some guests that the emotions have kind of run the gamut and stuff. That podcast, though, I think I had all those emotions on that.
Yeah.
I mean, he is a fascinating man.
John Vincent is coming to Club 400, man. And
yeah,
he's going to sign the wall this time.
Not only that.
Sign the wall.
He'll sign the wall. He's definitely going to sing. And last but not least, I think if you're nice to him, for sure he'll take a picture with you. He's a photogenic guy, right?
Of course.
But if you're nice to him, I think he'll let you try his ring on. He will definitely have the World Series ring. That's for sure.
Yeah.
Did you count the World Series ring as a guest?
No, but that we
just
could add.
It,
we
no,
could
no,
add
there'll
that.
Be an authentic World Series ring. Okay, go ahead.
Right. And you know, John is the sound of Wrigley, and our friend Wayne Mesmer too. I love him so much.
Both of them.
But you know what? We have to announce who our headline band is, man.
Oh my gosh!
I'm so happy about this. We're going to bring him on right now, the head singer of Pete's Diary, headlining Club 400, August 17th, Joe Maddon, A Night That Won't Suck. Let me introduce you guys to our good friend. Man, I'm so proud about this next announcement. Our headlining band, straight from Libertyville, Pete's Diary, man. William, unbelievable.
I thought this was Eric Clapton.
Dude, who plays that guitar, man? That's a mean-ass guitar.
I thought it was Eric Clapton or Jeff Beck or somebody. But
Club 400, God. How are we doing tonight? I got the main man. I got Pete on the phone. Pete Denkelson from Pete's Diary, weighing our event. Thursday, August 17th, Joe Maddon, A Night That Won't Suck, man. And I heard about you guys. I'm going to see you at the Vixen tomorrow night, and I am so excited. Pete, what is going on? Are you excited about this? I know I am. What about you, William? Are you excited?
I am excited, yes.
Hey. Yeah, this is going to be a lot of fun. We're super pumped up for the event. And, yeah, I mean, the Vixen tomorrow and everything, it's going to be a lot of fun. There's so many really fun gigs coming up.
Yeah, and I want to tell you exactly how we got how we found your band. And actually, I was, you know, as soon as we got the news that Joe Maddon, 2016 World Series manager, William.
I know, World Series champion.
Is coming to Club 400, raising money for Special Olympics. Who do I call first, William? Who do I call first?
Ghostbusters.
I mean, no. No. My guys, our band. Who do I call?
Modern Day Romeos.
I call Jimmy, buddy. Guess what? We just booked Joe Maddon. We're going to have a great time. Put it in your calendar.
He's like, gave him 3-4 months advance.
First of all, I should call Chris Perfect way before I call Jimmy. Jimmy is like, he can't even keep his room clean,
right?
So anyways, no, honestly, I call him up and I'm like psyched because I'm like, there's no way they're playing on a Thursday.
Right, you got him.
And then sure enough, they're playing on a Thursday. And we wanted to bring the whole modern day crew over here for the first time. But I said, Jimmy, man, what am I going to do? I need a band. I need a fresh band. I need a really good band. I need a band that plays a little Zeppelin. I need some classic rock. It's Joe Maddon. He's kind of a hippie.
Right.
And he paused, and he's paused a little bit longer, and it's like the light bulb went off in his head, and he goes, Pete's Diary, you need to have them play at your event. I said, Pete's Diary?
Who?
Never heard of him, you know? And no, he put me in touch with you guys. And I was so happy to book you. So, yeah, Pete, for all the people that don't know you or your band or your story, tell us a little bit about yourself and then how you got into music.
Yeah, so I guess with you know, the band with Pete's Diary, you know, we're a hard rock, kind of blues-oriented. I think it was a little bit tricky to hear, but I think I heard Crossroads at the beginning there.
Yes.
Okay, yeah. So, you know, Cream, you know, we definitely take a lot from all those great trios, but it's myself, Ryan on drums, and Mac is on a bass, and he does the lead vocals. We've been playing together for a few years now, and yeah, we've been having a blast. We've been playing all over the Chicago area. It's been a lot of fun doing all those shows.
So tell me, were these guys your friends for a long time? Or are these like buddies? And how did you decide to start playing with each other?
Yeah, it's pretty wild. We all knew each other through School of Rock, you know, the School of Rock program.
Yeah, there's a lot definitely.
Of different, there's a lot of schools around here in the Chicago area.
Yeah.
And we all met each other at Libertyville. Like Ryan was the drum instructor at the time. And basically, like when the pandemic hit, we kind of started jamming together. And like a little after the pandemic, we were kind of jamming and kind of writing riffs together. And then I've known Max, been a long time friend from School of Rock, and we got him involved. And he's a great guitar player, but he was nice enough to pick up the bass. And, you know, he's a great singer, too. So we decided to roll with the trio format and, you know, start doing local shows. So it's been a lot of fun.
And you play mostly like you said, 70s rock, 60s,
70s? Yeah. So, I mean, kind of that bluesy, kind of 70s inspired hard rock.
Is that like, were you guys all your favorite? Is that what you, is that how you landed on that? Or you guys, how did you come up with?
Yeah, I guess kind of like guitar style wise, or just kind of stylistic wise, you know, especially like, I guess I could speak for myself with the guitar playing. That's really where I lean kind of stylistically. So, and that just feels like a really natural, kind of comfortable spot that we all enjoy too. So,
who's your all-time favorite guitar player besides yourself?
No, I wouldn't pick myself at all. no, but I'm a huge AC/DC fan. Angus Young, definitely. Nice. He's my guy.
Okay.
So, Pete, when did you first pick up? I mean, you formed the, which is crazy. That's how new these guys are. And I heard like I don't know, and I don't remember the names, but someone said, oh, man, that Pete's Diary, man, they're good. And you know what the other guy said? He goes, oh, that's because they're actually really good and they're young and they bring energy. We're getting old, man, you know? Right. And like, yeah, you do bring fresh energy. But when did you first pick up a guitar? Because that's the one thing that, I mean, really, when I listen to Pete's Diary, the whole band's great, but, I mean, you really jam that guitar. So how long have you been doing that for?
Yeah, I first picked up the guitar. It was kind of towards the end of my freshman year of high school. Basically, it's kind of interesting because at that point in my life, my freshman year of high school, basically lots of kind of changes went on earlier that year. I moved states from where I used to live in Michigan to you know, of course, Chicago at the time. So that was a big transition with moving and everything and, you know, starting high school, of course, for the first time and, you know, all these changes that were going on. So music was a big, I guess you could say, crutch that really kind of helped me ease into all of these new transitions with starting school and, you know, all of these new surroundings. And then eventually just listening to so much music, you know, and rock and roll, really, I got inspired and really more than anything else, curious and interested in learning how to play guitar. And so I said to my dad one night, you know, I think it would be fun, you know, to learn how to play. And luckily for me, he played in high school and he has, you know, his guitar and amp and all of that stuff. So I got started on that and went on YouTube and started looking at, you know, chords and all of that, and basically never looked back. I was hooked right from the start.
Huh. I'm stunned that you've only been playing that long.
Yeah, because how old are you right now?
22.
Young guy. Yeah, can barely get a beer.
You sound like you've been playing since birth. I mean, it sounds like you were born with a guitar.
Did it come like naturally to you, or is it something that you really had to work at to be? I mean, or was it one of those things where you picked it up and, you know, some people are just naturally talented at things, like I am at this podcast, William.
I mean, I wouldn't say it was I don't think it was natural. I mean, I just work really hard, you know, and I love to play. I mean, I'm obsessed, you know. Even if I'm not, you know, playing the guitar, I'm always thinking about it, or like having one close by, or I'm looking at videos of, you know, my favorite bands or favorite guitar players jamming. Like it's always, I mean, it really is an obsession.
So how long does it take you to learn a song? You hear a song
it definitely depends on the song. You know, some tunes you could figure it out in a couple minutes, you know, maybe you could, you know, hammer a couple of chords together. Some tunes there might be some really complex stuff going on and you kind of, you know, there could be a lick or something that just feels weird under your fingers and you got to spend some time, you know, slowing it down and getting it up to speed and all that fun stuff. So it really does depend on the tune.
Yeah, I was going to tell everybody another thing that was important was, you know, obviously this event that we're doing on mm-hmm. August 17th with Joe Maddon, it's for Special Olympics. Yep. And it's all about overcoming obstacles, you know, and and like you've overcome a lot of obstacles in your life. Can you tell us a little about your personal story? Because I think everybody needs to know, like, you know, man, you've been through a lot and you've overcome it. Mm-hmm. And look at you now. I mean, you guys are up and coming.
You're a rock awesome star.
Yeah, you're a rock star. Yeah. Man, for crying out loud.
Bottom line. Yeah. You're a rock.
And did you ever even see this coming? But tell everybody about your personal story.
Yeah. So there's a lot that's going on. I'll try and summarize it up as best as I can. But basically, I was born with a rare medical condition called Goldenheart syndrome. Basically, what that means, you know, there's kind of, I guess, different things that can happen, you know, with Goldenheart syndrome. But like in my case, I was born with the big thing, you know, on the outside, I guess, is I was born with one ear. So I'm missing most of my left, pretty much, you know, all of my left ear. I have just a bit of the earlobe on the side. So I have a bone anchored hearing aid that helps me hear on the left side. And that works amazing. I really love that. But I mean, like I was asked about this today. I forget, but I've had over 25 surgeries.
Holy cow.
Quite a few procedures. Yeah. Just a few.
Wow. You've been through it all. That's a lot of surgeries.
I mean, lots of hospital stays, especially like, I had two like really big procedures in in high school. Let's see. I mean, some of the other stuff too. I have what's called a single pelvic kidney. So instead of two in the back, I have one in the front. So like when I was younger, sports was never an option. Like, unfortunately, like my brother, he played hockey all throughout, you know, school all throughout school. So I could never, I mean, I could, you know, I'd skate around with him a little bit until he could, you know, skate circles around me and make fun of me.
Yeah.
Dude, but, look at you now. Look at you now. Do you ever think like, this is unbelievable?
Yeah. But I mean, you know, lots of stuff that, you know, went on. And then of course there was, you know, the social stuff too with, you know, adjusting with everything socially, you know, with missing the one ear and all of this stuff. So lots of stuff.
And you're a motivational speaker, right? You do that on the side, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
Man, I would really love, you know, I know you're going to be jamming out here, but I would love to have you down. Yeah. You know, you are a part of the family going forward. So we want you to come to an event, maybe come as a guest, right? Down the line.
That'd be awesome.
I'd love for you to, you know what? We could use a little bit of motivation, right, William? I think society could as a whole.
You know who I'm really excited to introduce you to, who's going to be here that night as well? Maybe you've already met him, is John Vincent. Do you know who he is?
I don't think so, no.
He sings the national anthem for the Cubs and
the Packers,
and he does, like, big college basketball games and stuff like that. But he was bullied as a child, and he does motivational speaking as well. Like, he goes to grade schools and stuff like that and talks about bullying. I mean, he's engaging, great guy. Sounds like you guys would probably hit it off really well just because he's
totally.
A good guy and wants to share his story to, you know, help other people and stuff. People helping people, Cubs fans helping Cubs.
That's what we're all about. So I got to ask you, you know, you're young, you were born with this and, you know, I'm sure you had bad days. We all have bad days, but how did you stay positive and, you know, and just keep moving forward? And like I said, it's amazing what you've been able to accomplish. And I think it's the bright, they're just getting started, these guys, William.
Right.
Yeah. I think, you know, the big thing is, you know, if I am, you know, when I am having a bad day, of course, you know, the guitar, you know, picking up the guitar and just kind of playing, you know, it's such an expressive instrument, you know, especially with like, you know, it's a stringed instrument, right? And you can bend the strings in different ways to get different notes and you know, bend it to different pitches and all of that. So, you know, it's a very expressive instrument. You can express all these different emotions, whether you're feeling, you know, happy, sad, or anything else. The guitar is super expressive. But of course, my family, I can always count on them to have my back and friends as well. And of course, you know, the dogs, they're always there on a, you know, they're there on the good and bad days and are always, you know, cheering you up or, you know, whatever antics they might be up to.
Exactly.
So, yeah.
I mean, it's an amazing story. And I'm looking at William. We could talk to you for hours, man.
Yeah.
And, you know, and we will dive deeper in your story. And but I got homework for you. I got a homework. Yeah. So, okay. Yep. So you guys are going to probably play right at the beginning. All right.
Cool. Awesome.
But we're going to bring Joe out when after he gets here and we run him through the basement real quick. We're going to bring him out there.
Yep.
And I'm going to ask you guys to jam something, whatever you choose.
Okay. All right?
I want Joe Maddon to see you guys play because I think that's important because I want Joe Maddon to see, I want him to experience the whole entire event. But I want him to see you guys jam one song. So talk to the band. Figure out what song you want to jam in front of Joe Maddon. So we're basically going to bring him out there, and we're going to say, hey, everybody, I wanted Pete's Diary to play one track right now. This guy's an amazing guy. So that's my homework for you, all right?
All right.
And we'll surprise everybody with the guests, right?
I was looking up. I was doing some research on Joe earlier today, and your music is his wheelhouse. You know?
Oh, my God, perfect.
He grew up on the Stones, and he said he wished he had gone to the Dead concerts when Jerry Garcia was alive. He went with Theo after they won the World Series to Dead and Company and stuff. And so it's all, you know, just right up his wheelhouse. So I'm sure he's going to love you guys like everybody else here.
I my best thoughts come in the shower, William. I know it sounds crazy, but I was
TMI,
as Lori would say, TMI. All right, but no, I was like, man, you know, I was, you know, I'm always thinking, you know, my mind is always thinking, but I'm like, okay, what's going to happen here? You know what? I want Joe to see these guys play, you know? So I'm like, okay. We got to get on board with this idea because there's a good chance he wouldn't even get to see you play. So we're going to make sure you get one awesome jam out session right when we bring him out. It's going to be awesome, man. We are so looking forward to having you out to Club 400 and being part of the family, Pete. So I appreciate you coming on with us this evening, man.
Hey, yeah. Thank you so much for having me on. Yeah. We're really excited about this gig. We can't wait to play.
And we'll see you tomorrow night at the Vixen. I'm looking forward to meeting you and the guys and your mom and the whole family. So
absolutely.
You have a good
evening. That'll be awesome.
Yep. Yeah, you too, buddy. See you tomorrow, buddy.
Take care. Have a good
Bye-bye. Night. Take care, Pete. We'll talk to you, man.
All right.
Okay.
Thanks.
Salsa King of Chicago is a proud sponsor of the Iowa Cubs. You can pick up Salsa King of Chicago salsa at all Jewel Osco and Illinois Fresh Time Market stores. You can also enjoy the Salsa King of Chicago salsa during all Iowa Cup games at Principal Park. Salsa King of Chicago, salsa so fresh, it's like you made it yourself.
Ready. Well, you know what? Another thing I love about Club 400 is the food, man.
Food is awesome at Club 400.
So, like, when you buy a ticket to the Club 400 event with Joe Maddon,
you eat like a king.
By the way, I don't know if did I announce the price yet? $200 for a ticket. If you want a table, we have.
You know what? I'm kind of like breaking down the numbers. That's not even possible.
$200 a ticket, right?
Two autographs.
But we haven't even talked about that yet. Slow down there, okay?
Oh, slow down, cowboy.
Slow down there. So we're talking about the food.
Oh, the food.
Because we want to give you guys the entire. You know, I talked about this earlier. We want the win-win situation. We want you guys to come out and have a great time, eat some great food. So yeah, they really want to help out with this event. They want to be a part of the event. But we hired Smokin' Billy T and Bubba 2. They are Wonder Lake's finest. We are going to do our first ever pig roast at Club 400. And let me tell you what that pig roast is going to include. William, do you like pig roast?
I love pig roast.
Do you like barbecue sauce?
I do.
What's your favorite barbecue sauce?
Oh, my God. All of them?
No, like if you had to have one barbecue sauce on your fridge forever.
Brand?
Yeah, like what is your favorite? I want to know because I never asked you this.
It's an off-brand, but if I had to go into a store and buy a bottle.
Yeah.
Casey Masterpiece.
Oh, man, we are so different.
What do you take?
I'm doing open pit every single day, buddy.
Really?
Open pit is number one, man.
Okay. But my favorites are not, they're off-brand. You would be nothing you
like Aldi versions or something?
No. Like private label, you know.
It's fancy stuff?
Yeah.
Okay, whatever.
Fancy. I'll bring some.
So anyways, we are doing a pig roast.
Have you ever had the Chicago Salsa King's barbecue sauce? It's pretty tasty.
No, I haven't, but I hope they come out with one.
Oh, he has one. You just haven't. I was a sampler. Go ahead.
Oh, no, but honestly, this is the menu. I'm going to give you guys the menu, right? So we're going to have fresh food here. A pig roast.
A pig.
200, I think it's a 210 to 220 pound pig. A bunch of pork butts.
So we'll each
baked
get a
beans,
pound.
Mac and cheese, cornbread. Garden salad, coleslaw, but you're forgetting the best part, William. Cold Club 400 lager all night long here at Club 400 that night.
I was going to ask if the best part was the baked beans.
I mean, I love baked beans. I'm a big fan.
Are you a fan of the baked beans?
Yeah, I am.
I'm a fan of the mac and cheese.
Who is it?
By the barbecue people. Okay.
Billy T and Bubba, say hi to them. Wonder Lake's finest, man. Yeah. I mean, honestly,
they're in Wonder Techie.
They did the Ray Burr's event, and they did a great job. Not good food?
Oh my God!
Yeah,
and, that's off the charts, people.
You know what? It's the same thing, man. They really wanted to be a part of this event, and they're really donating their time. And they're not really making a lot of money on this stuff.
So if you set aside, I'm just spitballing here. Ten sure. seconds to spitball?
Spitball.
All right. If you set aside, let's say you and your wife are going out to dinner, just the two of you, decent place, and you're not drinking. I'm not sure why, but let's pretend you're not drinking.
Never happened.
But throw out a number.
Okay.
You're going out to eat. Decent place.
Number for what?
How much? Oh, no, you are drinking.
How much am I going to spend?
You and your wife go.
Oh,
dinner,
man. I'm
going to
spend, $100 at least.
Okay, $100. Okay.
At least.
All right. So you take 200 minus 100. So we're at 100. Okay. Then let's say you get all you can drink.
Say I mean, 30. To a point. Yeah.
Let's say.
Slow down there, cowboy.
Well, I'm just saying, 20 more bucks.
Yeah, well, we limit our alcohol here at Club 400.
No, I know. I'm just saying. But then, hypothetically, let's say you get an autograph of anyone. What's the cheapest autograph you can do today? $20? $50?
No, more than that.
$100?
More than that.
$200?
More than that.
What if he is a World Series
champion? No, I mean, honestly.
I'm just saying, $200? Yeah, it might sound like a lot if you're dead ass broke, but what you're getting, and then on top of that, it doesn't even matter what you're getting, right? At the end of the day, you're donating money to Special Olympics.
The plan is with all our sponsors, and we need sponsors, everybody. So if you know anybody who wants to sponsor this event, please tell them to contact us through www.club400cubs.com or on the Facebook page. You can reach
me. Or they can call us live during a podcast.
Exactly. So yeah, major big time pig roast barbecue, which is going to be great. And we want to thank obviously Chaz Herdrick, who's a good friend of ours, Robert Kusick, unbelievable guy. And like I said, we got a great menu, and it's going to be fun.
Joe Rodriguez affiliated with that.
Joe Rod, we love Joe Rod. He's an unbelievable guy.
Yeah, he is. He likes Mitch Trubisky, but he's a good guy.
I mean, he did, but whatever. Anyways, let's cue one of my favorite guys up here. So we're going to bring some other Cub players to this event, and I want to cue up. Let's just play the clip, William. All right? This is, I'll let you hear it first.
As Kennedy turned around and said something, as Denier sends it deep left field, going back and looking up is Martinez. It's gone. Cubs lead 1-0.
Schall throws a fastball. He's already behind in the count 1-0, and he comes in with a fastball up and out over the plate. And in this ballpark, when the wind is blowing out, you can see your left fielder doesn't even go back on the ball. It is no doubt.
84 center fielder, Gold Glove winner, Bobby D, the Deer, Bob Dernier in the house. Club 400, August 17th. Joe Maddon, an event for Special Olympics. What do you think about that, William?
I think if you're coming to this event, what you need to do, put on your bucket list for the event, you need to hunt down Bob Dernier and just talk to him for like 5 minutes.
Yes.
We had the opportunity.
Oh my gosh. So yeah, we're going to. So anyway, side story. I called William. I said, hey, William, we have this unique opportunity to go to the condo. And probably the appropriate time to bring it in, but we're going to meet Bob Dernier and the host of our Q&A with Joe Maddon, your finest guy, dude, a Club 400 family member, Ron Coomer.
To the crowd, buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack. I don't care if I ever get back. So it's root, root, root for the. They don't win, it's a shame. One, two, three strikes, you're out. Oh. We need a couple runs.
Yeah, we do.
So, William, like, we're hanging out in the condo. I said, let's leave a little bit early, right? First of all, Bobby D walks in with some friends. Next thing you know, Ron Coomer walks in. We just talked baseball for like 2 hours. Wasn't it cool?
It's so cool. And both of them just had stories after story. I could sit and listen to that all night, you know? And talk about, like, you know, it's always fun to get a picture with somebody, or people like to get autographs or whatever. We just hung out. We weren't like fanboys, you know. We were just like this. And by the way, kudos to them, because you know what? They treated us like we were buddies.
Right.
Like we just went to the game together, and now we're coming back doing the after thing, you know.
Right. I mean, it was a night that we drove home that night, and we just laughed the whole way home because we're like, who would have thought, like,
that we'd be doing that.
Yeah, exactly. We'd be hanging out with Ron Coomer and Bob Dernier, and we'd be talking about...
I've been a Coomer fanboy for a long time.
Yeah, Minnesota boy over there, huh?
He's probably not going to listen to this, but I've been a fanboy.
But yeah, honestly, it means a lot to us to have Ron Coomer back out here. Obviously, he came out here. Frank Schwindel, remember that, William?
Yeah, I do.
And we love Frank. And we're going to have Frank Schwindel on a podcast soon. I saw you hit a home run not too long ago.
Yeah.
We love that guy. So, yeah, awesome. Bobby D in the house. Who's our next Cub that's going to be here that day, William? Can you cue us in on that one?
In my job, signs are important. When you want real truck value, this is the sign to look for. They call me the Iron Man, but Toyota trucks are really tough. This Toyota 4x, comfortable riding, lots of legroom. Big on horsepower, tough and dependable. A workhorse, no matter what your game. For a truck lineup that bats 1,000, look for this sign and stop at your Chicagoland, Northwest Indiana Toyota dealer today.
Let me know when we're ready.
So you're probably expecting we're going to play the Jody Davis song. Jody.
Jody Davis, king of the wild frontier.
But we wanted
Jody,
to sing it.
Wait, time out. Let me finish, William.
Jody.
Catcher without a fear.
Okay, by the way, the best version of that song ever, I think, was sung at spring training a couple years ago. Remember when you got the whole entire section next to you to sing that to him? Called him from spring training game.
First of all, I'm a big fan of Jody Davis.
Who's not? Patty.
Patty. Patty Hart, one of the greatest. But yeah, true story. My grandma, who's like my second mother, basically, loved Jody Davis. My grandmother was from down south, and as you know, Jody Davis is from Georgia. And when my grandma passed away, I placed a autographed baseball in her coffin.
So, not knowing that, story about her, I've asked you maybe 10 times at events and things, is this surreal to you, having these guys in your basement? That had to be a little surreal the first time you like hung out with Jody, because I remember the first time I met him here, and he might have been here before that, I don't know. I was standing 2 feet from here at a bar top table. I was actually with Patty and Ruthie. And he just comes up and puts his drink down and starts talking. And we weren't talking baseball. We were talking about like whatever. You know? Just awesome. So it had to be surreal to you.
The whole thing is surreal. Like if you've been to a Club 400 event before, you know. Like, you know, you're basically in a small space. And there's nowhere. These guys can't run and they can't hide.
Right. Exactly.
So, I mean, we got other things to talk about here, William. So we're having two Q&As that night.
Two?
We're going to have Jody Davis, Bob Nardier.
And you and I aren't doing either one of them?
After Pete's Diary. No, we're not. I'm going to give you the night off, William. I want you to enjoy evening.
No, I'll
you
work. Know? I want to work.
Well, you're going to work. I'm going to put you to work. Security. I always put you to work.
Let's be security.
So, two Q&As. We're going to do one. Because the whole thing was my whole thought process was this, like, when I started falling in love with the Chicago Cubs, it was 1984. Maybe in early 1983, but like when I really fell in love with the Cubs, it was Harry Carey and the 84 team. Sure. And I thought they pretty much changed Wrigleyville into what it is today. And it became the cool place to be. And I just think the culture changed back then more than anything. And ever since then, I mean, I've been Cubs, you know, all along, so... And then, obviously, 2016, Cubs win the World Series. All their dreams, you know, come true. So my whole thing was, like, let's bring a little bit of 84 in this. So when I fell in love with the Cubbies. And then let's bring, you know, Joe Maddon out here and talk about the whole World Series venture, which is... So, yeah, Bob Dernier, Jody Davis will be a part of this event. I couldn't be happier, man.
So great. Yeah, so great.
So a lot of people ask me, William, like, what do you get for $200? Okay, William, can we review what we talked about so far? Let's see how good you are now.
So far, we've got pig roast.
Pig roast, all right.
Pig roast. We've got...
Who's singing the national anthem?
Johnny Vincent.
Who's our band?
Pete.
Diary.
Sweet Pete. And then we've got...
Who's our ex-Cubs coming?
We've got Bob Dernier. And we got Jody Davis. Oh, we also have Jeff Vukovich.
Nationwide is on your side.
Ex-Cub, Jeff Vukovich.
And who's doing the Q&A with Joe Maddon?
Joe
No.
Oh, not Joe. Joe, I was going to say Joe Kilgam, but he's the lead guy. My guy, Ronnie Coomer.
Oh, my God. Does that sound like a lineup or what?
Oh, my gosh.
So, like, okay. All right. We have this lineup set. All your money is going to go to Special Olympics. What do you get besides Club 400 beer all night long?
There's more?
No, I mean, what do you get besides just great company and great people?
That's what I was trying to establish earlier. Even just the dinner. You can't beat that. But go ahead.
Pig roast?
I think there's more.
Club 400 lager? You're going to get not
one.
I'm
guessing there's more because you use that word.
Well, you're going to get Joe Mann's book as a part of this event.
You mean a freaking hardcover book?
You're getting a hardcover book signed by Joe Maddon.
Are you kidding me?
Nope, that's part of it. You're also getting a picture with Joe Maddon.
Like a photo, like I get to stand next to him?
You're going to get a picture with him. You're going to say hi. You're going to get to meet him here.
Shake his hand, possibly?
We're only selling, by the way, 250 tickets.
That's it?
250 tickets. All the money goes to Special Olympics.
By the way, if you
you're going to get your picture with Joe Maddon, you're going to get his book signed by him, and here's the big shocker, the big news of the night.
Shaka-laka.
We are going to have our first ever Club 400 exclusive numbered item where you can only get it here.
What?
I'm excited about it.
It's so cool.
And it's going to be done right, guys. We done it right. We got the digital file from the Chicago Cubs. You are going to get a replica autograph Game 7 lineup card. And on the very bottom, it says manager's signature. That is going to be signed by no other than Joe Maddon. So you're going to get an autograph book, and you're going to get a unbelievable done. We have the digital file. We're not making copies.
And there's only going to be 400 made.
Only 400 made. Joe Maddon's never going to sign these again.
Why 400?
It's going to be the Club 400's first ever exclusive item and all money.
That's going
to
be
most important thing I want you guys to hear right now. All the money goes to Special Olympics Illinois.
So cool.
And let me tell you something, guys. The most important thing, you guys know it. I know it, William. You know it. The Club 400 community is unbelievable. I got Noah Ramos, our guy from Bar It Up, going to do something special. I got some other people. As you know, Dan St. Clair, one of our great artists, has a beautiful, beautiful painting that he's done with Joe. He's already signed it. Ron Stein, our good friend out there who does wooden artwork. Bill Watts, dude. How much do we love Bill Watts? Fly the wood, huh?
Bill Watts. Hey, Bill, I need one of your new wristbands.
Chris Lemke, bobbleheads.
What? My guy.
So we're gonna do it. We're gonna go big. We're gonna go big or go home. What do they say, William?
Big or go home. I love
go that. Big or go home. I think that's it. So here's the deal.
We have a password.
We have a password.
Let's go password and then rock them out.
So tickets go on sale next Friday. What's the date, William?
Today.
Can you look on your phone there?
Okay.
Next Friday, tickets go on sale to the public. William's looking on his phone right now.
I know there's a calendar on here somewhere. I got a clock.
I think it's the 26th.
There we go. We're the 18th. Okay, 26th.
Oh, see? 26.
Very good.
Tickets will go on sale
May 26, 2023.
Club 400 presents Joe Maddon, a night for Special Olympics.
And here's your password.
The password is, and it's all one word, lowercase. Shot and a beer. Go ahead. I want to thank you guys for listening to this podcast. It means a lot to us. And obviously what we're doing, we're obviously trying to drive you here because, William, this is a community, right?
Right.
And we love you guys listening. So here is the passcode, which will be released. Well, we already just gave it. You just heard it. Shot and a beer. That's S-H-O-T and a beer, all one word, will get you tickets before they go on sale. So they will go on sale next Thursday at 9 o'clock.
Only 250 available.
There's less than that, to be honest with you. So, Anyways, we appreciate you guys listening to our podcast, and we appreciate you being a part of Club 400 Cub Fans, helping Cub fans. Right, William?
Right.
We will talk to you soon. We'll see you at Wrigley Field.
Go ahead. Rock them out. Well,
if my words did glow with the gold of sunshine.